Buddy, it's Thuy again. I'm back for another tutorial. I just did this makeup look, kind of a daytime coral look. If you like it, keep watching. I'm gonna start off with the Stila Prime Pot just to prime my lids. You want to use your ring finger because that's the softest, and just it warms it up and melts it. I'm taking the Green Satin by MAC. And just a flat brush, eyeshadow brush, and putting that on the lid area. And if you don't have this, you can get something that is a few shades lighter than your eyelid color. And this has like a light shimmer. Okay, now I'm using the Coastal Scents 88 palette, the shimmer one. And I've got it here. I'm using these two coral orange colors right here. So the third one over and about the fifth and sixth one. And those two are the ones I'm going to use with the 217 MAC blending brush. So I'm going to grab the darker one first. Just go ahead and tap the excess off. You want to kind of go in circular motions right around your crease line and kind of your outer V, and just kind of blend that around here. The lighter orange color now. And just a little bit higher. I'm using this brown, this matte, just a neutral, regular brown color. I'm not sure what the name of it is anymore, but just a regular one. And I'm using this blending brush, and this one is a little bit more compact than the MAC 217 one. Just gonna pat that right in the corners. Back with the 217 brush and kind of blend it out in circular motions. Now I've got this slightly bigger flat brush, and I'm just getting the MAC Shroom. It's a lighter shimmery light color. Moving on to the eyebrows, I'm using the Lizette Eyebrow Makeup Kit. This is stencils for your eyebrows. And depending on your eyebrow shape, you would use the different sizes. But I'm doing number 3 because that matches my eyebrows. I will be using the MAC Mystery Satin, just a dark brown, with an angled brush. What you want to do is hold up the stencil to your eyebrow as close as you can to your shape and just go ahead and fill that in. If you feel like maybe there were some spots that were missed, you can touch it up and go over it if you'd like. Okay, now I'm moving on to eyeliner. I'm using the Stila waterproof eyeliner liquid. For the lower half of the lid, the bottom lid, I'm going to use black eyeshadow, a matte non-shimmer. I'm just going to use this little small angle brush. So any black eyeshadow, I prefer without shimmer, but if you want, you can have shimmer. I'm just going to get it right next to, right at the edge of the waterline. Waterline, and you won't have to worry about it coming off and smudging off. So about 3/4 of the way. And then you can wipe off whatever that was that got on your waterline. I'm going to curl my lashes, and I've got this heated eyelash curler. Just bought it a long time ago at Big Lots. Just put a couple batteries and it heats up. I'm going to use the Stila Major Lash Mascara. Some lashes. I just want the lashes that go on the outer corner, but I don't have any of those, so what I'm doing is using these Model 21 number 3, and what I'm going to do is just cut one lash in half and use those as end pieces. That way I don't have to buy the little tiny lashes. Lashes and glue, and I'm just going to add it on a light layer, but the corners are the most important to get. Wait a few seconds for it to get a little tacky. Close to the lash line as I can. So now what I can do after putting the lashes on is touch up any eyeliner that goes over the lashes to kind of conceal that line of the fake lashes. more coat of mascara and pinch the two together. Now I'm moving on to the face. I've already put moisturizer on and I'm going to use Stila concealer. Just right under my eyes to conceal any dark circles and on the sides of my nose. And you can put it anywhere you have dark areas that you want to conceal a little, even acne. And I'm using my ring finger to pat it because it will melt it and it warms it up. And your ring finger is actually the softest finger, so it helps not be too harsh. Especially around your eye. Okay, moving on to the face. I'm using the Stila Stay All Day 10-in-1 BB Cream. And I just want light coverage, nothing too strong. So I'm going to use my hands to blend this in again so that it can melt into your face better and your hands kind of give it that warmth. And it blends evenly. Set that with a light powder. I'm using the MAC Studio Fix in NC30. It's just a big brush. Now moving on to the cheeks, I'm using this coral blush. And I'm gonna use this angled brush. So what I'm going to do is tap that on. Kind of, you want to go in an angle at your cheeks, so that way it shows more of a higher cheekbone and it kind of slims your face. So what I'm doing is getting it more condensed here. Blending it up so that way it gives it a gradient. You want it to go lighter as it goes up. For the lips, I will be using the L'Oreal Pearly Pink 720. See that? This pink shimmery color. Right over that, I'm going to be using the Stila Lip Glaze in Cotton Candy.